dear friends of Catskill Symphony Orchestra. I'm sure each and every one of us has an interesting life story to tell. In the first episode of our series, I offered you a glimpse into my artistic life, focusing on a few works from my creative output. Like for many musicians, pursuing the professional career meant for me embarking on a journey in psychological as well as physical sense, in search of inspiration, knowledge, and sometimes simply looking for a new job. It all started with my first employment as a theater violinist playing backstage music. I was still a high school student then, and I remember very well that first job when, due to a movement on stage, there was a sudden draft that blew the music off my stand. Frantically trying to localize where it landed, improvising some crazy stuff that was supposed to be a quadrille, I finished that part of the performance on my knees. The search proved successful. I played the last two chords exactly as they were written in the score. Later on, I learned that my desperate fight with the wind deities apparently occupying the building caused quite a commotion among the actors on stage. Surprisingly enough, I wasn't fired the very same day, and my theatre adventure continued. Without waiting for a graduation diploma, I formed my own orchestra comprised of my colleagues who shared the same enthusiasm and sometimes recklessness. Joining forces with a choir I was also in charge of, we hit the road and went on a tour to Germany and northern Italy. And it was just the beginning of a fascinating journey. Some years later, this journey took me to the Mediterranean island of Cyprus, where I worked as the music director of the national orchestra. It meant immersing in the rich culture of that beautiful place, so blessed by the goddess Aphrodite, born, as the myth has it, from the foam off the coast near the town of Paphos. Savvas Savva, a friend of mine and one of the most famous Cypriot composers, wrote for our orchestra a concerto for 10 pianos. It required gathering of extraordinary resources, as you can easily imagine. First, we had to ask a building inspector about the permissible stage load. Then another issue arose. Putting on stage any random set of even the greatest pianos would pose an almost impossible task of tuning them all together. The Cypriot Ministry of Education and Culture bought then 10 new grand pianos of one brand. You would have thought that that might have been a gross profligacy in spending the taxpayers' money. Sure, without public support, such endeavor would not have been possible. But what to do with 10 grand pianos after the concert? So, the whole idea behind our event was to supply 10 public schools around the island with the best quality pianos to serve the music education. I still have beautiful memories from that concert. Savvas Savva wrote a piece inspired by the rich and complex history of his homeland. The concerto bears the subtitle Medieval Cyprus. Let me take you for a trip around that place. We will visit some of the most important tourist attractions: Aphrodite's birthplace, wonderfully preserved monuments of the ancient era, medieval churches and castles that remember the times of Richard the Lionheart and the Knights Templar, mountain villages frozen in time, together with spots of unspoiled nature.
Thank you.
I hope you enjoyed our little trip to the place that I hold dear in my heart. Let me take this opportunity to invite you to our next series, Conversations with Beethoven, where we will delve in the world of one of the greatest composers in history of classical music. Stay tuned.